Rodney Erdickson here, and this is my review of the game Titanfall 2 on Windows PC. Unlike Titanfall 1, Titanfall 2 actually introduces a single-player story mode campaign that you can participate in, and it's a good one. In Titanfall 2, Titanfall 2 takes place in the future. Soldiers now use these large mech robots in battle against one another, and in Titanfall 2 you control one of said mechs. Now, right now I'm piloting the mech. Generally mechs cannot jump, but what they can do is they can dash around using these jets on their back. Now, every time you use an ability, there's a cooldown procedure that you have to wait until your ability becomes available again. The Titans, the large mechs you control, have articulating hands, and each mech has these oversized weapons that it can use in combat. You start off with the expedition kit, which is what I'm using now, and through game progression you acquire more kits that you could change on the fly, which is kind of cool. As you can tell, in the expedition kit, you have this machine gun. You also have these other abilities. And by the way, every time you mouse over or you put your targeting reticule on an enemy mech, you can tell what loadout he has. So yeah, in the expedition, you have a shield that can hold on to shots and then deflect it back to the enemy mech. You also have, what do you have here? You have these rockets. And you have an electric smoke. Okay, that's the first kit. I can only show the kits I have unlocked. There are others I have unlocked later in the game, but it's fine. For the tone kit, you have this rifle, if you will. You have a shield that you can place. Oh, I forgot about the cores, sorry. The way a core works is it is a super powerful attack that when deployed leaves your mech vulnerable, but it's still a powerful attack. Like for example, in the first kit in Expedition, it's a rapid electrically charged fire mode. Okay, so back to Tone. As mentioned, Tone has this rifle. The mech configuration has a shield that you could put up. I guess I don't have any of these yet. Okay, sonar lock. So there's a missile of sorts that you could sonar lock on enemies. No lock on. I believe he also has rockets. There we go, that's a lock, right? There we go. Provided you have a lock on, you also have a rocket launcher. So yeah, the game controls, when you're controlling a mech, it controls very much like a first-person shooter. The mechs are kind of slow and laborious, it's to be understood, they're so oversized. You have these jets that allow you to dodge enemy attacks and move around quickly. Mechs can also run and they could also crouch. He has a brute loadout, which I'll try to show later. Oh, I got a lock on. Here, use this. There we go. I now have the core attack ready. When you defeat an enemy, you can pick up its battery. Okay, good. You will see my core attack when I get you in sight. Are you the enemy? You are the enemy. The core attack is a barrage of rockets. Okay, Scorch. Scorch is my favorite configuration, just because it deals the most damage. You have this fire grenade launcher. Do I need health? Okay. It also has a firewall, as it's known, which can deal damage. It has, if it ever comes ready, a fire... Well, wrong button, that's why. Ah, nuts. There we go. It has what's known as a fire trap, which, when ignited, will create an incendiary napalm mess. You have a fire shield. See, there's always a trade-off. For example, the Scorch configuration. Rocket grenades shoot one at a time and needs to be recharged, but it also has splash damage, which is nice. You're hostile. Ooh, shield. Fancy guy. Fancy. Let me use some of my abilities. Flame core, and it also has the core attack. It's just a devastating flame pounding of the ground. Okay, we got the Brute. The Brute has a rocket launcher. By the way, with the way the health bars work, the health bars are located in the upper mid part of the screen. You have the top bar and the lower bar. The lower bar is health that does not restore. For the top bar to deplete, every time the top bar depletes, you then lose a bar of the lower bar. The top bar will replenish itself, provided you do not, provided you stay in cover. So, this configuration, I believe I'm in Brute, has the rockets. It has rockets that follow your cursor. It has jump jets, so you can stay, hovering for a short amount of time to perform aerial attacks. There's a battery. Take it. These little peons you could just crush if you so wish. You don't have to destroy them. Ooh, but they do deal damage. Here, pop. Okay, that's my friend. My commander, actually. Retrieve the Ark. So I need to retrieve the Ark. Which way will I retrieve the Ark? There's not a map in Titanfall 2. But still, you have the objective that, in most cases, is revealed by pressing a certain button. And in this case, that's where I came from. And in this case, it gives me an idea of where my objective is. Time to make a big robot run. And make a dash for good measure. Okay. You got shields going. There we go. Whoops. Shot my friend. Oh yeah, you could shoot multiples. This configuration is very good for taking out multiple enemies. Okay, time for Flight Core. Here we go. Barrage from the sky. And all swings and misses, it looks like. Well, that was unfortunate. Next configuration, Ion. Got this energy weapon. Got what's known as tripwire. Tripwire? Oh yeah, I remember this. Okay, there we go. Creates like a... tripwire trap. Ooh, a laser it would seem. That is pretty useful. I got a shield. And of course every weapon or every ability after you use it has a cooldown, so you gotta wait if you want to use it again. Still waiting for my main ability to show it off in this class. As you can tell, there's a lot of... see, tethered, I'm stuck to a tethered trap. There's a lot of dialogue with the enemy mechs and you. Okay, you just blew up. Finally got my core weapon ready. Okay. Yeah, having fun? Just hanging out? Good to see you're busy. Okay. And this one running away. So yeah, the mechs, as they are, it's easy to think, okay, they require a pilot to pilot, but they don't. They also have artificial intelligence. This is how you find new weapons, as simple as that. I now have the North Star weapon for my Titan. If I have time, I'll show that off. So yeah, as I was saying, Titans have artificial intelligence. They can fight on their own. They can be on their own. But for some reason in the storyline, Titans are mated to pilots through a neural link. Take it easy. And through that, let's show my core attack. Laser core. That's a brutal attack. That's wicked. That attack is tremendous. Laser core. I know when the enemy uses it against me, it's devastating. So that's Ion. Ronin is, think of a Jap anime mech configuration, because it's got a sword. Okay, hey, another Ronin. So I got a shotgun. I could block things with my sword. I got a sword kind of laser attack. I don't know what exactly that is. It's kind of a masking. I'll wait till the tooltip comes up and it'll let me know what it's doing. Oh, you're friendly. Gotta watch my fire. You. You're looking pretty poisoned. By poisoned, I just mean damage. Arc wave. Yeah, okay, I know about that. That's the... yeah, that's what that is. Ooh, I'm about to perish. Grab batteries when you're weak. Okay, you're friendly. Yum, yum, yum. Okay, you're all friendlies. You have a shield now. Okay, sword core. Wait, the sword core, in order to use, you gotta be close up to an enemy. Because you're using a sword, literally. So, It's rare that a sword. I'm stuck in a trap. It's rare that a enemy will let you get that close, but. Here we go. That's a sword core attack. I neglected to mention that you could also punch, just punch with your with your Titan. You could do a melee attack. Okay, so that was that configuration. North Star. Now the gun on this works best when you charge it. But the thing is, if you're dealing with a an enemy who doesn't want to stay put, it's kind of difficult. Because when you use it just as so there, it's not very, just a quick shot, it's not very powerful. I'm going to grab a fallen battery. Last time I played through, I didn't do so poor, but I'm trying all the configurations for the video, so. Oops, stuck in a trap again. Okay, so, what do we got here? We got a rocket. Got jump jets. I could put out my own traps. Load it up. Getting the charge ready is difficult in this class. But if it contacts, it's pretty useful. Yup. I'll take more health. Why not? That last one I'll leave in case I need it later. As you can tell, there's small mechs and large mechs, but small mechs, I don't think they're manned by a pilot. I think they're just AI. In the storyline, of course. That's what I never liked about this configuration. The gun, if it's not charged, it's not efficient. Plasma weapon. Put the trap for you. Pop. I'm just waiting for the, here we go, flight core. Similar to another class. Pop, 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 pop. There we go. So, that's all the configurations of all available mechs, save for Legion, which is locked right now, so I can't show it to you. Back to my preferred class, Scorch. Get things done. There we go. Like I told you, fire damage is tremendous in this. Oh, look at this guy. Thinks he's cute. Ooh, that was bad. Should have been ready for that. Some of that sweet, sweet health. Of course, you could be defensive and, you know, dash away from attacks and what have you, or right now I'm playing in easy, so you could pretty much take them on head on. Also, I should note that this is one of the last levels in the game, so this is pretty intense. Pretty intense fighting. Small robots, when you kill them, or when you down them, rather, provide small batteries. There's also the large batteries, which restore much more. There we go. Small battery. Yummy. Okay, now who is I fighting? Retrieve the Ark from the IMS Draconis before it lifts off. Okay. There are checkpoints, and I can tell you the checkpoints are very, very, very useful. Because right now I'm showing off the mech, but when it comes to the first-person shooter aspect of the game, there's a lot of wall running and jumping required. And often it's, if you don't get it just right, you perish. Oh, got my famous flame core tethered. Just gotta shake it off. Okay. I got this. You're all weak. All my friends gonna perish. Out of the way, Sarah. Oh, these are all my friends. What's doing? Move, move, move. Okay. Killing peons on the floor. Ah, you are hostile. Oh, and you're taking flight. You're annoying me. Here we go. Boof. Wow, he dodged it. How sad. There you go. Hey, another scorch. I like the fire too, huh? There you go. Ooh, did you just use flame core on me? Ooh, I'm about to die. Just used flame core on me. I was not ready for that. There's only a battery there. Kind of puts me in harm's way if I go get it. But I do need it. Oh, I didn't make it. As I mentioned, it's a good thing that there are checkpoints in this game. Because sometimes you need them. Okay. Oh, you're hostile. And you're my class. Oh, I had this ready. And this time it made contact. Good for me. Downed him. Put up a shield, really. So you could imagine how this game plays in multi. Oh no, I'm in the napalm. Stupid of me. That was a melee attack. Wrong button. Hi. Ah. Flame core. Oh, he's using the core against me at the same time. Bad time to reload. They pop around, I pop around. It's a lot of popping around. There we go. Okay, I need that precious little battery. Oh, can I melee you? There we go. Melee is not insta-kill as it is when you're in first-person view, but it can wield a lot of damage to an enemy. Problem is that, of course, the enemy will rely on it as well if you're in close quarters. Okay. As you can tell, pilot in the mech. Since it's a neural link, the mech does what the pilot does. Waiting for the story to progress. I don't quite remember if... Yeah, this is not the mission I want to show. So as you can tell, here I am in first person view, and that is my mech. As mentioned, my mech has artificial intelligence, so he is he is sentient, he is aware. But at the same time, for some reason in the game, these mechs work best when the pilots, such as me, are piloting him. This right here is a lot of scripted event. I don't remember if waiting this transition is worth it, but anyway, I'm gonna wait it through. What's nice about your mech is that since it has artificial intelligence, it will essentially converse with you, and there is an adventure game elements in Titanfall 2 whereby if your mech can give you instruction or make an indication of sorts, at which point you can you have a dialogue that you could choose what to ask your mech, which is kind of fun. I can tell you right now, that mech right now, that Viper mech, is the most difficult enemy in the game, I feel. Right now I'm falling. But, scripted event. The game has a lot of fit and polish. A lot of intense vignettes, as we just saw, and it really is really well produced. What's happening here is what's known as a fastball. It's where your mech will throw you. See? I could give him dialogue. I'm gonna ask, "Are you sure about this?" And he says, "Trust me." And I've been thrown. There we go. When in first-person shooter mode, you have... Whoa, don't fall off. Oh, I fell off. That's thus the importance of having respawns, checkpoints. It's kind of hard to do this without audio, so I know when to jump. There's a specific time. Time your jump. Thank you so much. Here we go. So, I don't know if you noticed, but on foot, you have your own specific jump jets, which allow you a secondary jump in air. Ooh, a lot of this game is about jumping and wall running, which is actually well done. It's actually fun. It never gets too tedious. The ballistics in this game, and right now I'm using energy weapons, figure that out. The ballistics in this game are very rewarding. Every shot feels impactful. Feels like you down your enemies. The defeat animations are well done. If you get headshots, the helmets pop off, which is a good indication. Show a different weapon. There are energy weapons and ballistic weapons. What do they have? Hemlock. Let's switch up. Spitfire I just got rid of. As you can see, you can pick up enemy weapons, which is useful. I like the HUD, if you notice. This problem could be argued it's taken from Halo. On the AR itself, I could see how many rounds are in my clip. Oh, these are robots. With the robots, you don't go for headshots, you take out their legs. Then they crawl at you, which is kind of fun. See? Just like that. Which point then you go for the head. So, like I was saying, in this particular rifle, you have the magazine round count displayed on the actual weapon. And when you zoom in, it's the plate displayed in your sight, which is cool. Again, it should be noted I'm playing in easy, so not to think that this game is complete cakewalk. It would help if I could shoot too. What I like about this is you could slide on your knees to take out enemies. That's really well done. Again, I'm kind of disappointed that there's no... Ooh, too close. Kind of disappointed that there's no proning, getting on your belly. Okay. So that was Hemlock. Fire Star, that's a projectile. I saw Volt. Here we go. Volt is a energy weapon, I believe. Okay, where was I going? Here we go. So, overall, in Titanfall 2, in the story mode campaign, you're looking, if you rush through it, you're looking at maybe 5 hours of gameplay, which is not great, but as you can tell, look in the background, it's an emotionally charged 5 hours of gameplay. It's a rewarding experience. It really is enjoyable. What do we got here? Spitfires, I don't like. I don't like. Volt, I'm using. Okay. So, I guess I got a double jump here. Pop, as you can tell. Pop in there. The audio in-game is really well done. The soundtrack is very, it's orchestrated music, but it's very appropriate. It's provides a good ambiance for the actual gameplay. Well, you are disabled. Oh, not you. Ooh, bad time to reload. There we go. They get too damaged, they self-detonate. Oh, a Mastiff. Let's try Mastiff. Oh, it's like a shotgun? Yep, it's a shotgun, alright. At times, you can use robots to your own advantage. They're called strikers in-game, sorry about that. And here's a perfect example of how this game works. Okay, you're gonna stick by me, you're my protectorate. Look, I can't make that jump, but what I can do is wall run to make the jump. And it's pretty seamless, it works pretty well. Are you friendly? You're friendly. You now have no leg, but you're friendly. Okay. And there are some pretty crazy areas you have to traverse through wall running and jumping over and over and over. It's really, really, really interesting. I played through the game completely, and I can tell you that there's but one area where I feel it was badly executed. It has to do in an area with cranes, and most of the time I was practically climbing the cranes to get the proper jump that I need, and that felt... unnatural, if you will. So... that was the one time when I didn't care for map layout, but other than that, the maps are pretty well laid out. Map design. Oh. Okay. Rendezvous with the 6-4. It's a good thing you told me, or else I would have kept on running. There they go. They're ziplining in. Certain points in the game you can... ooh, what do I say? Just doing my job. That's cool. The scripting and storyline is well done. The acting's well done. Oh yeah. Now you're gonna see my fellow soldiers how they do it, and I have to do this. They used a different ramp. I don't need a debt ramp. Run! 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 Oh, do I make it? Maybe I did need a ramp. Oh, how sad. Everybody else did it, but not me. Okay. Forget you guys. I'll do my own thing.
No!
I double jumped too soon, huh? Do I grab? Okay, I made it. To get the most flight, it always helps to time your double jumps to get them just right. Oh, just like a fire weapon. I didn't even notice. I thought it was just like a shotgun. I've never used this in my last playthrough. Oh, but it takes time to reload. Okay, double take. I know what the double take is. Oh no, that hurt me. Oh yeah, you also have grenades. I seldom use them. Here, grenade. I guess grenades might be useful for the shields, huh? So yeah, the storyline, the dialogue, the scripting, it's all very good. The experience is very rewarding. So that being said, that... Okay, I don't know what that dude was doing. It kind of makes up for the but 5 hours of storyline gameplay. Because it's a... Yeah. Okay. 4 out of 5 hours are good. It's still that map where you were... Where I had to climb up cranes was a little much, and it got a little tedious trying to find the right way. And still, the way I found, I don't even know if it's the proper way. In the end, it worked, but it felt as if I was not following the designated path, because I was literally, like, quadruple jumping to climb up cranes and using cranes to propel me to where I needed to go. It didn't feel like it was part of the path, but... Either way, it's a small criticism, considering that the game was just all in all really enjoyable. Really, the fit and finish on it was really well done. It didn't feel buggy, which is important in these games. And, whoops, what's going on? I say that not being able to climb a staircase for some reason. Anyway. Here's another scripted event. Boink, boink. Am I ready? Ready. Breach, breach, breach. So yeah, there was, in the storyline, there's a lot of emotion, there's a lot of, Ooh, what's that? A handgun. Don't quite use handguns much. Storyline was enjoyable. It was interesting. It keeps your attention. It's quite a good adventure and quite worth the time and worth the effort. Is it worth the money? I purchased Titanfall 2 on special, so I definitely got my money's worth. Paying full price? For the single player? I guess if you're really bored and you have the disposable income, maybe. Here's a perfect example of... Your mech has its own artificial intelligence, and this is how you transfer. So yeah, very rewarding experience, very enjoyable game, very good storyline, very well produced. One criticism, and it's a minor one at that, was that I could not, the audio. You can't specify which audio elements you would like to increase in volume and which you would like to decrease in volume. Which is, you know, frustrating. Because... As I mentioned, the dialogue is well produced, the script is well produced. You actually want to hear what's going on. Problem with that, of course, is that the combat, especially in a mech, is so loud. So if you're wearing headphones, that really really enclose your ears. It can be quite intense. And unfortunately, in multiplayer, you can adjust the volume sliders for individual things, but not in single player. Single player just has a master volume, which is too bad. I would like to prioritize the dialogue and maybe diminish sound effects, considering how intense it is. But guess you can't have it all. But that's a small criticism. Other than that, game was very enjoyable. The script was very enjoyable. The battle in the mechs, like right now, like I mentioned, in my opinion, this was the most difficult boss in the game. It took me a couple of tries to beat him. And as it's showing right now, I'm not making light of the situation. Nonetheless. So yeah, if you get the game on special, you want a good single player experience, good story mode campaign, definitely recommended. If you're paying full price, maybe wait for a special unless you're really bored and you have the disposable income. Well, there you go. I'll leave you with that. I hope this information helps, and as usual, all the best.